You hear things, yeah. You know what? I've known you actually a bunch of years since I started doing this show. I've talked to you about a lot of things. I never talked to you about your childhood because we both come from
Boston.
We both come from Boston, and I don't get an image.
Were you a comic book guy?
Yeah, my brother was a big comic book.
See, I was a big any comic books.
Kind
of. Did you ever order things on the back of comics? The X-ray specs. Remember with the.
Yeah, you thought, yeah, you could actually, they said if you put them on, you could see the bones in your hand.
Yeah, but what the glasses had were bones painted on the inside of the glass.
That was the thing. And they used to have, the other one was the sea monkeys.
Yeah.
And the sea monkeys playing the ukuleles, right?
Right, right.
And the mom sea monkey would have her hair in a flip like Marlo Thomas, you know, and the kids all in.
The last thing I ever ordered from a comic book was something called Monkey in a Teacup. You know what that is?
Never heard of that one.
No. Well, in the back of the ad, they show this little monkey in a teacup doing this, you know, just sitting there. It was like $4.95, which was a lot of money when you're like 12.
Mm-hmm.
So anyway, I order this monkey in a teacup, you know, and I'm waiting. You know, it's like 6 weeks. When you're a kid, it might as well be a year. So this thing comes in the mail, and it's like this package like this. So I come home one day, and my mother says, there's a package for you on the dining room table, and it smells terrible. I said, oh, it's my monkey teacup. I can go in, and the package is doing this. I'm like, it's not terrible. So it smells awful. It's got holes in it, you know. And I open the box, and this thing goes, this thing, it was completely pink. It was a little naked man. It wasn't monkey at all. Just some kind of thing goes, like this. And my mother goes, and it goes, it just takes off through the house, right? It just starts running through the house. So my mother starts chasing it, and she's hitting it with the broom. And I'm going, stop, you're going to kill my monkey in a teacup. And it just, it runs up, and it's just throwing things. And then it would go to the middle of the room, stop. And it had like males. It was like a little naked man. And it looks like this. And then, boom, it takes off again. And my mother is just screaming, chasing this thing. So finally, she opens the front door, and the monkey's, boom, runs out into the field. Woo, woo, the dog is now chasing the monkey in a teacup, ran outside. We never saw it again. I don't know what it was.
No, what are you talking about?
I don't know what it was.
What are you talking about?
It was a little pink naked man that was this big. I don't know what it was. And I wrote to the company again, and they were out of business, and that was the last one they had. But I never...
It's water.
It ran into the field, and that was it. It was mine for like 10 minutes.
Can't we find out what the hell that
was? I don't know what
was?
It was. It was just monkey in a teacup. That's what it was.
Don't tell too many people about this,
Jay. It was a little naked, hairless man. It would make this noise, and it would run and then stop, bam, and then take off again. It would stop long enough to see it naked, and then run. You know, I don't know what it was.
It was a little pervert.
I don't know what it was. It was just a little man, monkey in a teacup. That's all it was.
Don't tell anyone else this story.
No, I've never told that story.
No one tell anybody.
No, it's a true story.
Now, one thing I've noticed is that